like to cover some basic features in the Fabric Portal and help with overall familiarization and navigation of the portal itself. So I like to think of the Fabric Portal as being broken up into roughly three functional sections. And those include ordering new things and services. So fabric ports, network edge devices, IP blocks, precision time, so on and so forth. Creating connectivity between those ports, devices, maybe either to ones that you own or outbound to some sort of vendor or service provider. And then lastly, managing that stuff. So things like viewing port statistics, email notifications, access control lists for network edge devices, and even submitting trouble tickets. Now this bar up here at the top is going to be our main means of navigating the portal. And under most of these categories, you'll see a corresponding inventory section that will take us directly to the inventory for that section in particular. Alternatively, we can go to inventory here and jump straight to our port inventory or device inventory and so on and so forth. So let's head to connections inventory first. Now you'll notice under the connections inventory, I can view things like the provisioning status of the connection. I can view the access point and location. I can also change the view here on the side to be either a spreadsheet style view like this one, or more of a tiled grid view like this. And additionally, I can click any of these categories here and I can sort by whatever I choose. So in this case, I could sort by company name, I can sort by location, and so on and so forth. Now these same tools apply if I go to a different section. So say my virtual device inventory. And I can view the status of these devices. I can view the model. I can view the location. I'm going to head to fabric ports next. And again, over here, I can see the location. I can see the bandwidth. I can see the encapsulation type. And I can also see the cable ID. Let's click on one of these ports here to get a closer look. So this gives us a more detailed view here. You can see I can view things like the UUID of the port. I can see the port encapsulation type, .1Q in this case. I can also view the TPID. I can view whether this is a primary or secondary port. The bandwidth, of course, I can see some port statistics for it here. Of course, I can see the metro. And a little further down, I can view things like the patch panel information. And this is all useful if I were going to, say, submit a trouble ticket. And in that case, what I would do is I would grab this UUID. I would head up to this support icon here and open a support case. In this case, we're submitting a trouble ticket for a fabric port. So I'm going to head to ports. And this is exactly where I would dump that UUID. And it's going to search and find it for me real quick. And then here I would include any illuminating information about what I'm seeing wrong, what's going on, and then I would hit submit. Now, there's definitely plenty more to cover here in the Equinix Fabric Portal, some of which we've already tackled in previous videos, such as ordering Equinix Fabric Ports and creating network edge devices, and many other topics, including things like service tokens, service profiles, and device link groups, to name a few, warrant their own discussions and will be covered in future videos, so stay tuned and keep an eye out for those. Until then, as always, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.